Hello and welcome along. Today on Smokedown Farm, we are going to set up our fertilizer spreader here to do some spreading via course play, including the function to automatically refill itself. So we're going to record that course first and save that. While we wait for our tractors to finish doing their seeding, so we have the 6616 doing beet on this field, and we have the 7726 doing barley on one of the others. So once one of those two is finished, I think it's the 7726 is going to finish first, so we're then going to do barley manually on field 8, as it's a much smaller field. So let's get going. So we will start up this, and we are going to record a course from here. So this is our refilling course. We will come off the track so that it doesn't damage the tractor. So the idea behind this is that when the tractor runs out on the field, using this as a combined course should refill it. So we'll hit reverse. Oh no. Right, and we refill. I might have to redo this course because I think that was a little bit close. We will do a test drive of it. Okay, we're going to abandon this course as I messed it up a bit. So back to the start. Through the cow pasture. Right, we have time on this field to set this up, so. Right, so here it goes. So, start course recording. So put it in traverse, switch around. Yeah, there we go. Take it out of reverse. Head back. There we go. So we stop that and we will save that as field 31. Refill fertilizer. Okay. And as we have that saved, we will then clear that. And we are looking for fertilizing and seeding. We are doing field 31. Check our working width. Starting corner is southeast, going north with one round. Right, and then we will save this. So F31 fertilizer spreader. There we go. Okay, and then we load another course onto this. So refill fertilizer. And then that creates two combined courses. Hopefully, we should be able to start this here. First waypoint and drive course. And there it goes. Hide most of these. So this now, we keep an eye on it. We will go and see what our other tractor is doing. So that one is still doing that. This has finished. So we then clear that off. Now I think, yep, our little Massey is down that corner of the field as well. So we will use the Following Me mod to take this. Right. So with this, we're going to go and seed barley on field 8. I don't think we will need to refill seed, but we will take little Massey with us. Hopefully that will make it out of the gateway. Yep. Oh, what's happened to it? Ah. There we go. And this trailer is, we have to avoid the big puddles, otherwise we run into problems. Right. So there we go. Ah, so this one has run out, so we will have to take our little Massey over there and refill that in a moment. So, open that up. drop this down. Nope, I'm gonna drop that one down. And jump into our other tractor. Ah, we're not quite close enough, so we will just maneuver this. There we go. So that is now full. So lift that up and load it all back on, and we will now head over and fill up our other tractor. So the auto, the refill setup with Courseplay, you can do with something like this as well. So I can park this at the side of the field and set up a refill course for this as well, which is quite useful. Yeah, you can have several bits of Courseplay going at once while you're managing bits and pieces. One of the nice bits about the dirt mod is that as this field has been cultivated, it's a little bit more difficult for a little tractor like this, which doesn't have a lot of power, to drive over it with a fairly heavy trailer. And I'd probably be better off with a different service trailer with this tractor, but I like this little service trailer. There's a lot of interesting functions to it. And you have to deploy these in order to fill things up, and things like you've got the lights over here. So we want to stop this at the moment, and then we want to fill it up. Get back in my little Massey. Show you the big work lights that exist on the back of this trailer. So pressing M puts that up, and then you've got all these work lights that you can just light up a field, which is, it's fantastic. So bring that back up, hold that, let's bring those back down. And then we'll get this out of the way. Back this up slightly. Drive course. Right, so this is now down to 7%. So we'll just check that this actually does run on its refill course. I think it's right. One of the things I'm going to miss immediately with FS17 is Courseplay. It allows me to do so much, so well, so quickly. Right, so here we go. Our last... Right, so there we go. It's actually taking a course very similar to our tractor and trailer did before. Now, I am slightly worried that our seeder is going to run into traffic with our little Massey, so... Seems to take a much more measured way of driving. With course play on this through the mud, which is good. Ooh. It's not perfect. Ooh, it's very much not perfect. But it seems to be doing the trick for the most part. Yeah. Yeah, I think there are some improvements that can be done on that course. Oh, it looks like it solved itself though. Yeah. It could do with some improvements. So we'll move our Land Rover out of the way. I think doing it with something on the field would be better. Not quite sure where it's got something in traffic now. So we will stop driver. Hopefully this will continue from where it left off. Seems to be heading roughly in the same direction as where it left off. Yeah, this is where it turned around. So, and there we go. Off it goes. So, not perfect, but pretty close. And that's how you set up a course play with an auto refill. So we're going to park this here, and get working with this. Right, so we're going to start here. This is not a very big field. This shouldn't take us too long to do. luck. Slightly strange shaped field. So on the, on American maps, as we've seen, I'd use GPS for this. You can use GPS at slightly odd angles, but on English maps there aren't. Well, in my experience, I've not seen it used that much. Admittedly, I haven't worked on a farm for a few years now. That, well, it's certain that technology has moved on. I certainly wouldn't expect to use it on a field of this size, though. But you know, let me know. Feel free to leave us a comment. Larger part of this field down this end. So our next pass, we want to do the headland up there. So actually, probably not. I think we will go around and do all the headland at once, rather than, and we will just not quite go far ends this time. We want to go to about here, I think. Of doing it manually, as opposed to course play, of course, is that stuff doesn't get missed so readily. As he comes in at a really odd angle. This Down we go. Yeah. So now we will go around to do the headlands. I should say you miss a lot less when you're doing it yourself, rather than you get that field, because obviously we just missed a bit off that corner. Two tracks working with other fields seem to be conflicting with each other a little bit. I don't mind missing a little bit in the corner. There we go. So if we just do a quick check, we have fields 1, 2, 8 and 31, and 31 is currently being seeded, and all the others have been. So that is all our fields that we have to planted. So hopefully next week we will be able to do some more harvesting, and hopefully get our first sugar beet harvesting, as we've not done one of those yet on any of my maps, or any of the maps that I've done. I'm very aware that where I want to park this is where our fertilizer truck goes and gets stuck. So we're going to have to park this and then check it out. What we might do is redo the refill path so that... Oh, there it comes. Yeah, doesn't quite go far enough. Of course, the beauty is we can just get it to redo that path. So what we'll do, actually, is we'll take it over. So that once it's full... Right. We'll stop that. Yeah. So the great thing is, if you keep the refill parts separate, then you can get it to... that's not what I want to do. I'd like to get the sugar beating corn cedar in next to it if I can. There we go. So we will park this up. We have three crops to harvest. One of them, of course, being corn harvest, which we have. And is still to be done. And we want to hire a forage harvester for that, ideally, I think. This will be interesting because the other one, the seeding tractor, is also going round and it's going to be very close. I don't think this can get past it. Ah, it's going the same direction. So as they're both going round the field, they should miss each other, which is great. So, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, please like, comment, and share. And for all the latest videos from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.